Hi, hello, good morning. It is a pleasure to introduce myself to you. I'm Ramna. You're watching Deeksha Medical Channel. Today, we're going to learn about the second type of tissue is the simple cuboidal epithelium. Generally, simple cuboidal epithelium is made up of, it is a single layer of cells. And the shape of the cells are cube-like. Each cell contain centrally located nucleus. So simple cuboidal epithelial tissue associated with, that means what is the role in our body? Mostly it is useful for the absorption and secretion. Some areas excretion also takes place. So we can say excretion also. Right? Now where it is found in our body? You know, vesicles of thyroid gland, you know, largest endocrine gland in our body is the thyroid gland. Thyroid gland is made up of structural and functional unit of the thyroid gland is vesicles. So these vesicles are made up of, the vesicles are made up of simple cuboidal epithelial tissue, right? We will see the diagram. Next, acini of pancreas. Acini is a specialized cells which are in the pancreas. Generally pancreas is mixed gland. They have both exocrine and endocrine. The exocrine cells which are responsible for secretion of pancreatic juice. Right? Next, sweat glands. The sweat glands are meant for production of sweat to make the body cool. So sweat glands also made up of simple cuboidal epithelial tissue. You know, choroid, iris and ciliary body of eye, these three are part of second layer of the eye which are made up of simple cuboidal epithelial tissue. And a tubular part of nephron, mostly tubular part of nephron is nothing but PCT and DCT. PCT, abbreviated form PCT. PCT nothing but proximal convoluted tube, and second part is a DCT, distal convoluted tube. These two parts we can see in the picture very clearly, right? So proximal convoluted tubes, distal convoluted tube, both are parts of the tubular part of nephron. Next, epithelium, also known as germinal epithelium. Why it is called as a germinal epithelium? Because it is present in the gonads. Gonads in females, ovaries are the female reproductive organs, testes are the male reproductive organs. Both ovaries and testes togetherly called gonads. Ovaries produce ova, testes produce sperms. That means the simple cuboidal epithelial cells get modified into the germinal epithelium. That germinal epithelium helps to form the sperms and ovas. Then last part is the inner ear parts of membranous labyrinth. Generally inner layer basically made up of labyrinth. One is bony labyrinth, one is membranous labyrinth. Bony labyrinth which make the channels of inner ear, but membranous labyrinth which make the lining of the channels, right? These all are useful for absorption, secretion, excretion. Now we are going to explain about modifications of simple cuboidal epithelium, right? These cuboidal epithelial cells, right? Generally it is present on the basement membrane. Sometime this apical surface of the cell get modified to do particular function, right? So based on the cell modification, there are two types. One is brush bordered epithelium, second one is a ciliated cuboidal epithelium. Brush border cuboidal epithelium and ciliated cuboidal epithelium. In the brush bordered cuboidal epithelium, it is mostly located in PCT. You know, PCT is nothing but proximal convoluted tube of the nephron. They have the apical surface of this cuboidal cells which are present in the PCT area. They are get modified into microvilli. So this type of modification we can call as a brush bordered cuboidal epithelium, brush border which look like a brush, right? And these are mostly present in the PCT, which is responsible for reabsorption reabsorption of nutrients. Next, in the DCT, it is present. In DCT also contain the cuboidal epithelial tissue, but does not have any type of microvilli. That is only just it's a flat surface, right? Okay, now that's a major difference between PCT and DCT. Both are related to the nephron. Next part is ciliated cuboidal epithelium. It is present certain parts of nephron and collecting ducts are there. That means if you see the picture, you can understand where the collecting ducts are present. That lining of collecting ducts are made up of ciliated cuboidal epithelial tissue. Last lecture, we talk about the characteristics of cuboidal epithelial tissue. On it, we made some questionnaires. Let us see. The first question is, what is the cuboidal epithelium? What are the characters of the cuboidal epithelium? Option A, it is composed of single layer of cube-like cells. Option B, it commonly found in ducts of glands and tubular part of kidney. Option C, takes part in secretion and absorption. Option D is all. So you find the answer and write in comment box, and if it is a right, I will give the a compliment. Otherwise, I will give the right answer, right? Second question goes to, that is, epithelial are involved in all except, there is epithelial tissue, we have seen epithelial tissue, different types are there, simple epithelium, compound epithelium. So this epithelial tissue involved in all, that means what are the options I have given? In that, which option is not related to epithelial tissue? Option A, protection. Option B, connection. Option C, secretion or excretion. Option D, absorption. The second question also, find the right answer and write in comment box. And if it is right, I will give the comment. If it is wrong, I will give the right answer. Thank you.